Harp, I want to let you know YouTube is censoring probably some of my talks, even though I'm a small guy. I don't have many followers. But when I come on here, I'm methodical in my speech. And also, I understand politics. I don't have the time because I'm trying to take care of my family, but I'm building the time because this is most important. And I need more subscribers so that I can be here often. And that means that I'm more relevant in this space. So subscribe to my channel, and please do subscribe. And I'm going to come from another area in my talking points from another device because I've been having problems with my last three sound bites. What I want to do is discuss right now the actual exchanges that we're dealing with here and what we already know. Obviously, we know what it is. And it's unfortunately white supremacy. We know that. That exists no matter how many white friends you got. They will also admit white supremacy exists and it's alive and well in our nation. And we also, the white supremacy is the head of what everything causes. Even when immigration come in the country and decide to have a certain bad talking point against descendants of slaves. You know, this conversation is starting to be more precise. Because we're not just talking about black people. Everybody always use the word black people. Even I use the word, oh, they have something to say about black people. Black people this. We got to stop using that term black people. We have to use descendants of slaves because black people are not descendants of slaves at all in this country. Black people can be Africans who furthermore have an iota, practice an iota against descendants of slavery. The Negro is what's in trouble. It's what's been under America. The Negro, the descendant of slavery in terms of the law and policy. In terms of being under something and without, not black people. Now, we know John Botham was, you know, murdered by Amber Geiger. But, of course, that was very, you know, peculiar and God rest his soul and his family. Of course, they acted different than we would act in dealing with police in court. Somebody shoot your family member for no apparent reason going into the house. But they got dealt with because that was a situation where there was a white person dealing with a melanated person. However, his family came to the United States to build wealth, and that's exactly what they were doing. John Botham, whatever his name is, Botham guy who was murdered, he lived in an upscale community. His family is here, basically in the shadows of our country, building from the wealth of this nation and the advances of this powerful nation that were built by slaves, descendants of slaves. My family, my blood lineage, who built this country, who put this country, engineered this country, and been the battery of this country's success. See, so we got to understand, we're not black people. We are Negroes and American people. We are descendants of the American slaves. We are descendants of slavery. And we have been forced to live in a certain space. And when we did get a hold to something, we further went under because of exploitation, not being truly corrected, not being truly honored by government, not physically being physically honored, having internal politics where it actually is in our environment and it's effective. We did not get that. We didn't get no money and no land stating that this is your protection. You go and do what you need to do according to the way you are anchored and treated, which was inhumane. And it has been abolished and amendments has been documented and written and signed and sealed for you to advance in your life. That's something we haven't received. We had to fight wars to get each thing. After the slavery was abolished, we had to go now and work on cotton fields for sharecropping. My grandmother and them, they was family members were sharecroppers and stuff. You understand? They became school teachers and all that, but their mothers and stuff were sharecroppers. And we had to live this life and fend through Jim Crow. And all of these laws had to be changed throughout the war and the hurricane of slavery. I call slavery a hurricane because in a hurricane, you get many storms. You get floods. You get lightning flashes. You get tornadoes. You get all kinds of things. You get hail. So slavery is the hurricane of America, the hurricane of our struggle. Because slavery put us in a place where now we had to go in the crevice of every corner and fight for each law according to our lives. throughout years and rumors of wars and street wars where our family members came up dead. The KKK ran my grandmother and them off their land. Hell, my great-grandmother, she had 11 children by a man who was supposed to be slave owner. But they say he really didn't own slaves. He didn't want to. He had 11 children. And his name was Nate Johnson. Let me tell you, I am the descendant of slavery in the United States on both sides of my family. My father and my mother are both children of the descendants of slaves. There are people alive today can tell us what they had to struggle with. My granddaddy fought in Top Sergeant War. He couldn't even vote when he came back from the Vietnam, from the Korean War, because he was discounted as a human. He had to go home like a child because the laws wouldn't respect him. And right now, if you look in the books where they come from, Mississippi, it is still illegal for black people to vote documentary. But yet they honor it because they know it's a shame. Because we are a beautiful, intelligent people. We're grown people. We're not children. That's the thing that white people don't understand a lot of times. And the America has not given and America has not honored our policies. And this is dangerous and it's unconstitutional. And it's deplorable in terms of what you're doing to the society when you do that to this many people. In terms of accessing something different and shaping their communities and then giving it to other people. We got people in this country riding who we are just to advance, you know, and they've been doing it a long time. We got political party fighting who basically demised the existence of the American Negro, the existence of descendants of slaves, but yet they're fighting in their behalf. And sometimes the fights fall into terms to protect us, but they're not trying to protect us. That's how manipulated the law has been with us. That's how much litigation we are in with the society, with the government, the United States government. Because if you want to know, for instance, when Trump got president, when he started fighting to get illegals away, that was to help us. But I don't think he really realized it. But mostly he was doing it because they've catapulted themselves so much to their in white people way. Because white people and the powerful businessmen and big government and the big business allowed them to use our amendment right. And that's birthright citizenship where their children are born and now they become politicians and they are taking jobs that belong to white people and in communities and exploiting and it's a culture shock. And they catapulted themselves because, you see, those businessmen got comfortable with giving something away that don't belong to other people. And they should have been correcting us in terms of what they've done. And I'm going to tell you of what they have allowed to happen throughout a power source. See, so we have to be careful and understand what we're doing. We have, you know, white people talking right now, saying the most stupidest things. Just asking dumb questions. You got a white man under my commentary asking me, how do you know Obama? How do you know black people was voted Obama in? You love to ask people stuff and stand over people and quote stuff like you, the one with all the sense. And just as dumb as a bag of rocks. You don't even know history very well. All you know is what they tell you. And your whole livelihood, whitey, that's not to attack you, is built up on a false sense of reality. It's a lie. Everything about you is a lie. The only thing that you are able to do is to pillage people by some heinous togetherness you have and tell the story of other people's success and take the credit of patents, inventions, and everything, and put a face on it and add a dollar to it and make it a brand and say that you built the country. And other people built this country. My family built this country. And what by now we should be able to partner and understand this, and you cut the check in terms of what heinous act you did, especially if you're going to do it for some Jews. Gave them a blank check, the government. The main government or whoever you want to be, federal government, you gave them a blank check. And don't be trying to squeeze us together with no black and brown. Don't nobody need to have a part of what we need and what we're supposed to have. This is our nation. We built it. We suffered in this nation. We were born and bred here. Some of us born and bred like cattle. We're people, and we're grown people and intelligent people, and have proven it. And we've been exploited by the United States government and the source of power. And our politicians have not spoken in our behalf in terms of this out of a fear tactic. And this is where it stops. So cut the check.